Hi, Grade 7. Welcome to another exciting edition of Mr. V Teaches Math. Today, what we'll be looking at is comparing and ordering fractions. This matches up with 5.4 from the textbook. And again, because I like sharing the goals with you, we're going to be comparing and ordering fractions and mixed numbers using equivalent fractions, which is something that we did in 5.2. So if you need to rewatch that, feel free to rewatch it. Hopefully, I can help you out with that as well. So that's what we'll be doing today. Now, I have a bit of a problem, and I decided to write it out. We're going to be ordering some fractions from least to greatest. So the problem is that I have four grade 7 students, Jeremy, Isaac, Jesse, and Nicole, who are working on homework. Jeremy is 7/12 done, Isaac is 7/8 done, Jesse is 2/3 done, and Nicole is 5/6 done. I'm curious, who is the least done? That's what I want to know. Okay, so I think what we're going to do is we're going to have a second sheet of paper, and we're going to write out these fractions. So we have 7/12, 7/8, 2/3, and 5/6. Now, what we're going to start by doing is we're going to think back to some stuff that we talked about a few units ago about something called greatest common factor, because we need to remember that topic, that technique, to help us out with equivalent fractions, because what we need to find is something called the lowest common denominator. I'm not sure if that's a new topic to you. I don't think it's going to be, because I seem to recall doing something in the grade 5 or grade 6 textbook that had to do with adding and subtracting fractions. So what we're going to do is we are going to write out the denominators, 12, 8, 3, and 6. And I'm going to use this method, just writing out multiples, to try and figure out which is going to be the smallest number that comes on each list. So I did 12, that was 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, 3, 6, 9, 12, and just keep writing them out. Now hopefully what we have noticed once I've written some of these out is that there is a match on all lists, and it happens to be the number 24. So we can say that 24 is going to be the lowest common denominator of 12, 8, 3, and 6. It's the smallest number that will appear on each of these number multiple lists. Now, knowing that is going to enable us to find equivalent fractions to be able to put these in order. So here's how that works. We take our first fraction, which is 7/12. And like last time, when we did equivalent fractions, I know that I want to get to 24. So I know that's 12 times 2. And what I've done to the bottom, I have to do to the top. So the equivalent fraction to 7/12 is 14 over 24. Okay? And that's for Jeremy. Jeremy's got 14 out of 24, 14 24ths of his homework done. Okay? So, oops, sorry about that. So that one's done. All right, on to 7/8, which is how much Isaac has done. To get from 8 to 24, I have to multiply 8 times 3. And again, top and bottom need to be multiplied by the same number. So 7 times 3 is 21. Denominator is 24. This is how much Isaac has done. So that one's finished. Then Jesse, having 2/3 done. I want to get from 3 to 24. It's 3 times 8. Which means it's 2 times 8, 8, there we go, ish. So I get 16 over 24 for Jesse, and that's done. And then lastly, Nicole, I want to get from 6 to 24, so it's 6 times 4, top and bottom times the same number, which gives me 20 over 24 for Nicole. So if my original question was who has the least done, what I can do now is look at all these numerators and see which one is the lowest number. And I have seen that Jeremy has the least amount of homework done. So I'm going to write that one first, 14 out of 24. Okay, then Jesse has 16 out of 24. Nicole has 20 out of 24. And Isaac has 21 out of 24. So Isaac actually has the most done, and Jeremy has the least done. Okay, Isaac just beat out Nicole to have the most homework done. Okay, that's how the lowest common denominator works. You're going to need to become really familiar and comfortable with figuring out lowest common denominators, because if you want to be able to add and subtract fractions, you have to know how to do that. Okay, now we've written it like this. What I would ultimately like it is if we headed back to the original form. So putting it in order, we have 7 twelfths, then 2 thirds, then 5 over 6th, and then 7 over 8. So that's from least to greatest. Okay, least is over here, and then moving its way to greatest over here. So that's the first problem. Okay. Next thing that we're going to be doing is we're going to be comparing fractions. So the question that we're working with is, which is greater, 2/3 or 3/5? Now again, you need to understand common denominators. You need to understand that stuff, right? So if we use the denominators, we can do the same method. We have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21. I'm going to stop at 24. Because I bet you know what number we're going to come to. 5, 10, and then 15. And then hopefully what you see is that 15 is the first number that occurs on both lists. So I want to get from 2/3 to a number over 15. And to do that, I have to multiply 3 times 5, which means that 2 also has to get multiplied by 5. So 2/3, the equivalent fraction to that over 15 is 10 over 15. Likewise, with 3 over 5, I want to end up with a number over 15. To get there, I have to multiply 5 times 3, and then 3 times 3, which gives me 9. So then which is greater? Well, that means I'm working with 10 over 15 versus 9 over 15. And since 10 over 10 is bigger than 9, we can say that 10 over 15, or 2/3, is greater than 3/5. Okay, so that's how that example works. And again, we're finding common denominators so that we can compare the numerators, which is the important part. Okay, next method, we're going to look at using mixed numbers to see which is greater. Okay, so here we have two numbers, 2 3/4 or 2 4/5. Which one is bigger? You can make a guess, but we can figure it out. Now, the common denominator between 4 and 5 happens to be 20. Okay, so the 2s ultimately are going to stay the same. To get from 3 over 4 to 2 and a number over 20, I have to multiply 4 by 5 to get there, which means I multiply 3 by 5, which means that the number here is 15 over 20. I notice I changed it up just a little bit, but I'm still doing the same thing. And then 2 4/5, I want to get from 2 4/5 to 2 and some number over 20. Now I have to multiply 5 times 4 to get to 20, and 4 times 4, which gives me 16. So that means that I'm actually comparing 2 15 over 20 versus 2 16 over 20. And again, we get to compare numerators now that we have the same denominator. So I can say that this one is bigger. Okay, so I can say that 2 4/5 is bigger than 2 3/4. Last example, this is slightly different. This is going to be using decimals to see which one is bigger. And the way that we do that, when you want to convert a fraction to a decimal, you get out your trusty calculator and you type in the numbers, 5 divided by 8, so numerator divided by the denominator, which is 0.625. So I can say that 5/8 equals 0.625, and I can say 4/7. So get my trusty calculator out. I do 4 divided by 7, which gives me this big long number, 0.575. just stop it at 5, 7, 1. Because what we do is we basically look and see which decimal is bigger. In this case, 0.625 is bigger, so we can say that 5 over 8 is bigger than 4 over 7.